that way, we can reach in, we can grab the pipe. It's not a pipe, it's a plastic pipe. Pull down a little bit of plastic on it so it doesn't stick to it badly. We already have it hollowed out and the sides of the pipe. Oh, thank you very much, that helps. We hollow the top up here. All the way down this way. Well, we also take it off this stand, this one, the normal, with the newspaper, the station. Hollow, hollow. Let the bottom get stiff for a day or two. Then we lay it down, hollow out the bottom, and we do it in stages, guys. If you take it, I don't know if y'all were around last semester, but one of our illustrious superstars over here took it a little quickly, and it was great because she did it exactly the right width, but it was still a little wet, and the next thing that happened was she was about 4 inches tall. Somehow we propped it. So, we have newspaper. How do you put the newspaper around? I put it like this. I don't know why. It has to be clockwise, but that's the way I do it. And we need a, I don't even unfold it or take an example. Try to get it right. Right amount, then you only have to put one go round for newspaper. So I test it first just to see how big it's going to be. First I'm going to get the pipe. By the way, it doesn't matter if you have 2 inches in. It doesn't matter if it's too short. It does matter if it's too tall. So check this out. I'm testing. By the way, the tape over there, this is almost a two-person job. The tape is for your second person. I don't know. the fuel kind of twisted. That's about right, man. You don't want it too tight because this will swell up a little bit when you draw moisture, and it's going to get some of it. I think that's okay. And I don't even know that I'm going to take it. I know. Normally I have to tape it because you had to do this a little bit. That's the base movement. That's not the... Y'all follow what I'm talking about? It's not the armature itself. Well, it is the armature itself. It's not the finished paper you give me. I think this is sufficient, as long as y'all follow what I'm saying. Now, the plastic, I would get a little bit of plastic. Don't put a whole plastic sack on this, but tear you off a little piece, wrap the thing, and just tape it lightly so the plastic stays where it's supposed to be. Got it? Put some newspaper, put some plastic, put some. There you have it. This is ready to go. Whose is it? Flip the coin. Hi. Hi, Dave. There's your paint. Idea is we are going to build up clay, a lot of clay, because your head is big, all three of you. I wasn't going to say have the big head. We need more clay under here than you really have, because I need clay out underneath the chin until this gets stiffer. A week or two from now, it will be like a vertical pole, a lot of clay. Eventually, we'll take this off and we'll put it out here on your shoulders. I mean, it's not like we're not going to use that clay, but everybody follow what I'm talking about. We're just going to make a vertical shaft. Two-thirds of that square from the front. In other words, once we get enough clay on here, what we will actually do is make it flat and two-thirds the width, just like we did on those very small clay, our small skulls. Does that make sense to you? You do it by, you take one of these, an extra one of these, beat it, it also packs your clay. We can't start out with a bag of clay here. You gotta start out with a bunch of pancake pieces of clay that you have dried and are stiff. You're gonna put them, slap them on there to try to keep the air out of it, but also try to go on there with your hands and eventually take something and actually beat on this thing. And it will compact that clay like it needs to be to support itself. two, get yourself going. I need these done. I need them almost. I need clay on there today, guys. You need to hope you got your muscles working.
I wore a t-shirt.